This video presents material on the epidemiology of tobacco use, including the relationship between tobacco products, users and involuntary users, tobacco product manufacturers, and environmental factors. Tobacco use is the single most preventable cause of death in the world, killing more people than AIDS, tuberculosis, and malaria combined. Nearly 6 million people die each year from tobacco-related diseases, and this number is expected to rise to 8 million by the year 2030. 1 in 2 smokers will die from smoking. When used as intended, tobacco will kill half of its users. Many of the leading causes of death around the world, such as cardiovascular disease, chronic obstructive lung disease, and lung cancer, are caused by tobacco use. The smoke produced when a cigarette is burned, known as secondhand smoke, also contributes to morbidity and mortality. Exposure to secondhand smoke occurs in homes, at work, and in public areas, and puts many non-smokers at risk, including children and pregnant women. Worldwide, at least 40% of children and 33% of non-smoking adults are exposed to secondhand smoke. The Western Pacific region has the highest rate of secondhand smoke exposure, with more than 50% of the population exposed to secondhand smoke. Secondhand smoke is responsible for 10% of tobacco-related deaths, and 28% of these deaths are children. Tobacco comes in many forms, and whether it is inhaled, sniffed, sucked, or chewed, there is no safe way of using it. By far, the most common form is manufactured cigarettes, which make up 96% of tobacco sales worldwide. Other forms of smoking tobacco include bidis, popular in Southeast Asia, and heavily smoked in Bangladesh and India. Kreteks, which are clove-flavored cigarettes popular in Indonesia. And water pipe, also known as hookah, shisha, hubble bubble, and nargile. Its use is most prevalent in North Africa, the Mediterranean, and parts of Asia, but it is also increasing in popularity in other parts of the world. Types of smokeless tobacco include chewing tobacco, such as zarda, gutkha, and khaini, which are popular in India and Bangladesh, and moist snuff, which originated in Sweden but is increasing in popularity globally. 20% of adults around the world smoke cigarettes. In 2009, 5.9 trillion cigarettes were consumed. That's enough for every person in the world to smoke 865 cigarettes or 43 packs. Cigarette consumption was historically highest in high-income countries, but it has been steadily increasing in low- and middle-income countries due to increased marketing, increased social acceptability, continued economic development, and population increases. Between 2000 and 2009, cigarette consumption increased by 57% in the Middle East and Africa, by 48% in the Western Pacific, by 24% in Europe, and by 11% in the Americas. The top 5 countries for cigarette consumption include China at 2.3 trillion cigarettes per year, Russia at 390 billion, the United States at 316 billion, Indonesia at 261 billion and Japan at 234 billion. In India, the consumption of manufactured cigarettes may seem low at about 100 billion. But if BDs are included, the consumption would be close to a trillion. Manufacturing tobacco is a profitable enterprise. In 2010, the six leading tobacco companies' total combined revenue was $346.2 billion. Their combined profit was $35.1 billion. These profit margins are equal to Microsoft, Coca-Cola, and McDonald's 2010 profits combined. While the majority of tobacco consumption in the world is through cigarettes, smokeless tobacco is an increasing problem. Containing the same carcinogens and toxins as cigarettes, some smokeless tobacco products combine tobacco with chemical additives and other ingredients that may pose additional risk to the user. In addition to causing some of the same diseases as smoking, smokeless tobacco use also increases tooth loss, precancerous mouth lesions, and gum disease. In some countries such as India, Bangladesh, and other countries in Southeast Asia region, more tobacco users use smokeless tobacco than smoke, or they do both, which is known as dual use. Specific health consequences from combustible tobacco use and smokeless tobacco use are well documented. However, less information is known about dual users' additional risks. Dual use is concerning because it has the potential to prolong nicotine dependence and slow reductions in prevalence. Countries generally go through stages of the tobacco epidemic over time, and we have seen a pattern develop with the smoking prevalence and smoking-related deaths within countries. In the first stage, smoking prevalence increases within a country and deaths caused by smoking are small. In the second stage, the prevalence increases rapidly and smoking-related deaths begin to rise. In the third stage, smoking prevalence peaks and begins to decline, but smoking-related deaths increase more rapidly. And in the fourth and final stage, smoking prevalence continues to decline while smoking-related deaths continue to rise. High-income countries are mainly in the fourth stage, whereas low- and middle-income countries are in the second stage. In fact, worldwide, 80% of male tobacco users and 50% of female tobacco users live in low- and middle-income countries. In adolescence, the difference in the rates of smoking between boys and girls is much smaller than the difference typically seen between men and women. In 25 countries, more girls smoke than boys. Overall, we see that the majority of smokers begin smoking in their youth. In the United States, 83% of smokers begin smoking before the age of 18. The same pattern is seen in many other parts of the world. Many youth start smoking due to motivation by peers, the desire to appear cool to friends, the persuasive tactics used in tobacco marketing, and the availability of affordable tobacco products. Additionally, girls may smoke because of the belief that it will help with weight loss. Women in developing countries often start smoking due to the tobacco industry's marketed association that smoking makes women equal to men in power and independence. In addition to the direct health effects tobacco use has on people, the tobacco epidemic results in costs to society. Direct medical costs of treating tobacco-related illnesses can be significant. For example, in Egypt and Mexico, over 10% of healthcare expenses are spent on treating tobacco-related illnesses. Direct medical costs don't account for the indirect costs of tobacco use, such as loss of labor productivity, cigarette butt littering, and fire damage from cigarette use. Tobacco use is expensive to society in terms of healthcare expenditures and lives lost. While the epidemic is decreasing in developed countries, less developed countries are in the early stages of the tobacco epidemic. There are multiple forms of tobacco use, and patterns of use are changing. Fortunately, there are proven population-level policies and strategies, such as smoke-free air policies, cessation assistance, and taxation, that when implemented fully, can help make the next generation tobacco-free.